as we have moved toward the electrical designing portion of our series, we are going to make legends, and this is a simple JPG file, and I'm going to give the link in the description. First of all, I have opened a new AutoCAD file, and I'm going to change the units, and I'm going to set the units, and I'm going to match the units of my floor plan. They were architectural and with a precision of 1:4. Now after that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to open the insert tab that is just beyond this home tab, and I'm going to click this attach button, and from here I'm going to attach this JPG file that I named as legends, and I am going to insert it in my drawing. So I'm going to specify the points on the drawing or on the screen. So I am attaching it on the origin that is 0,0. Here I'm going to specify the scale of this drawing as 20%, but this won't make any difference because this is only going to make it look bigger. But if I'm going to trace anything on this file, the size of the actual drawing would be the same. So after this, I am going to select this, and I'm going to fade this a little bit because we are going to trace the legends out over this file. So the idea is to make the symbols individually and make blocks of it and then import it in the next file. So here I'm going to only trace those symbols that I'm going to use for the electrical designing of my house, and I will be making the blocks of only those as well. Say for example, here I am tracing out with the help of the line command the television symbol because I'll be using it in the electrical designing of my house. The line width here that is selected is quite thick, but still line width here in the drawing is 10. So I'm going to open the properties, and then from here I'm going to select display line width. And then I have traced out the light fixture, and then I'm tracing the wall mounted light fixture, under cabinet light. There are switches, so I am going to make 3 of them. Let me tell you that an S indicates a switchboard, and the lines in this switchboard indicates the number of switches on that switchboard, which are commonly called gang in the designing firm. Now I am going to change the size of this, as this is quite big. So let's employ the hit and trial method. Select this and give it the size of size that is that looks okay. So I think yes, this is okay. Then I have copied these, made 3 copies of this switch, and I'm going to make 1 with 1 switch and 2 with 3 switches and another one with 2 and another one with 4. So these are actually switchboards with 1, 2, 3 and 4 switches. And then I have traced out this GFCI, and we'll discuss what these are. These are actually receptacles, or you can say sockets. And this is a fan. I've traced this out, and then this disconnect switch. And this disconnect switch is usually for the ACs, and then electrical panel, exhaust fan. I have used SPN line for the exhaust fan, and I have used here polygon command of 3 corners, so it will be a triangle, and this is a dedicated supply, and this dedicated supply is usually for the fridge or if you have some fixed fixtures. Now I'm going to save this. After saving this, I'm going to use the scale command, and I'm going to scale them as to the 20% more size, because I have already compared the size of a legend, if it will be comparable or if it will be suitable for the floor plan view. And you can do it by making a single block and then importing that block to your floor plan. So I have here already done that. And if you're not using the same file of legends, then you're supposed to do that before you start making the blocks of each and every symbol. And I am going to select this, and then this is here. And one thing more, that I have here selected these and changed the layer to dev points. And this is the layer you're never going to make your legions, because if you're going to make the legions on the dev points layer, then it won't show up in your printout or in your paper space. So here I have opened the layer properties, and I have selected the zeroth layer, and if I want, I can make a legions there too. The difference between the two is the blocks made on the legends layer or the zeroth layer are going to retain their property no matter where they are imported and on what layer they are imported. And if you make your blocks on some other layer, that is legends layer that I have made here, then if I'm going to import these blocks that I'm going to make on the legends layer, they will take up the shape or the properties of the layers in which they are imported. So this will be demonstrated in the later videos. If you didn't understand this, you don't have to worry much. For now, I have selected the zeroth layer, and I am making my blocks on the zeroth layer. I am here selecting each legend individually, and I am making a block. For making a block, select your legend or symbol and type block command, and then specify your insertion point, that when you will insert the block, where you want the insertion point to be. So specify that insertion point, and then you are done with the block. And then you can name the block whatever you want, but it is a good practice that you give the relevant names that were written on the my legend sheet that I imported. I have here kept all the blocks on the zeroth layer, but to experience yourself what is the difference between the legends and zeroth layer, I would advise that you keep one block at least on the legends layer and the rest on the zeroth layer to experience the difference. Now we are almost done with our blocks. In the next videos, we are going to do the electrical designing of this house. Hope you have understood how to make the electrical legends, and we will continue in the next one. That is it from this